Well, today's the day. I think it's probably the last day leaving Casa Calabrese. Not easy. Kind of a sad day. Actually, really a sad day. Been with this boat for 11 years. She's been a great boat. Been through a lot over those 11 years, to say the least. There's Johnny's, what he likes to call his park, the new AstroTurf extravaganza in the backyard. Well, the lift will be gone in a couple of days, and a new boat will be back in the berth. Hopefully, if all goes well, by Sunday of this weekend, actually, Sunday of next weekend, I'm going to be picking her up in Alabama on Wednesday, March 3rd, and hope to arrive, fingers crossed, by Sunday, March 7th, at which time the old lift will be removed by DKM Boat Lift, Dave McGowan, and he will be installing the new lift in the next couple of weeks, a 27,000 pound four rail from Neptune. Incredible company. It's really helping me out with the timing here, both Dave getting the old lift out and getting the new lift in. It's been a little bit of a juggling situation with the lifts, because both boats are without bottom paint, and so there's always a time fuse with leaving boats without bottom paint in the water, obviously. So timing is really of the essence, and when we got back the final survey from the manufacturer Pursuit for the new boat with a clean bill of health, the owner obviously wanted to get moving right away. It's been a long process, but we're finally at the feels like the 10-yard line. So I just want to give a shout out to Dave McGowan at DKM Boat Lifts and Neptune Boat Lifts, obviously, for the manufacturer. So I just thought I'd do a quick history of the boat and a little, sentimental journey, if you will, as we take her over to Nautical Ventures. Adriana there has been absolutely amazing, and we're going to probably have some minor engine work done just to get her in tip-top shape. And then they're going to likely be the assigned broker to find a new home for Not Easy, which I hope will be an owner that really appreciates her. She's been a great boat. She will continue to be a great boat. It's a great boat manufacturer, Jupiter. And it's just the best all-around boat from Fort Lauderdale, in my opinion. Just growing out a little bit out of it with the family and whatnot. Needed something a little bit more enclosed, a little bit larger. Not getting too crazy. It's a 365i Pursuit, 2015. And very excited about it. So we'll go on a little drive here. I'll tell you a little story, and then we'll be bidding farewell to Not Easy. Okay? Beautiful day. Really couldn't ask for anything better than today. Bye-bye, 13th Street Canal. Okay, so the story you've all been waiting for, the saga of Not Easy. So we're going to rewind the clock to about 2010, when I was relatively new at Guggenheim, and my intrepid sales manager at the time, who really kind of was the icebreaker for me setting up an office in Fort Lauderdale, was my good friend Scott Loretti, who happened to be based in Savannah, Georgia, of all places. Not bad. Skidaway Island. And I told him that, after he was part of the process of allowing me to set up shop down in Fort Lauderdale, along with Ron Arvelino, obviously at the helm of making that decision, I told him I was interested in buying a boat, and he was a boater, and kind of commiserated around that. And he said, you know, I just happen to have a neighbor, pretty well-to-do guy, who's got a bunch of Ferraris and a bunch of boats, and I think he's probably due to sell his center console. And I said, oh, that sounds interesting. Why don't we put me in touch with him? So turned out it was a 2005 31 Jupiter center console Cuddy. At the time it had 200 hours on it on the 225 Yamaha four strokes, and boat was garage kept and kind of just in immaculate condition. I've never seen a boat so clean. Even the drain scuppers in the compartments in the deck, the little well in front of the drain, was completely clean and waxed. So I knew the boat had been taken care of really well over its life, and so that gave me some confidence. So I went down to see the boat. I forget when it was, what time of year, probably around May, I think. And bought the boat on site. No survey, no nothing. Just took the guy's word for it, handshake, met with his day-to-day mechanic guy, showed me all the records, looked good. And that was about it. And I think that same day, Scott Loretti in his 35 Everglades center console with one of the colleagues from work, Chuck Hendricks, and myself with another salesman at Guggenheim, who the name escapes me right now. I'll think of it in a second. But we embarked on a trip south to deliver the boat. Now, at the beginning I thought that Scott was going to join me the whole way. Ended up not doing that. But that was okay, because he made it about halfway. With air traffic here. Going through the Port of Everglades right now. Here you got some decent sized ships. That thing's a monster, brand new it looks like. And so anyway, we embarked south and was cruising along on the intercoastal in the Georgia, southern Georgia area before we crossed into Florida, and man, that was awesome. Some marshes and, you know, just beautiful winding, intercoastal through the mangroves, and there was no speed limit, so we were just cruising along on glass. We made a lot of great headway, and then we popped outside, and we got to Fernandina, pulled in there, had lunch. Beautiful little town. And then we scooted on our way. I think I did a trade actually while we were at the dock. And then scooted on our way further south to what was originally going to be Cape Canaveral. And it just so happened that there was one of the last, if not the last, shuttle launch that weekend. And so we get down to, it was too rough to get to Cape Canaveral, so we pulled into New Smyrna. And because of the shuttle launch, there was literally no available rooms. We actually looked at one room that was in a flea bag motel that looked like there was a pool of blood on the floor. So we decided not to do that. We were in the marina. We decided to overnight. So not easy. You know, everybody mocks me because it's a Cuddy, but in times like these, it really comes in handy. Because wouldn't you know it? We had an overnight on the boat. So me and my colleague, sales colleague, another grown man, slept in the Cuddy cabin, whereas my partners in crime, Scott Loretti, slept in his coffin-style bunk in his console on his 35 Everglades open bow. And Chuck got the short stick and slept on the padded open bow area out in the open overnight. So, needless to say, we wake up the next morning, refreshed. My colleague and I was a perfect sleep. We had the hatch open, got a nice breeze, and couldn't have been more rested. Grabbed a cup of coffee, walked over to the Scott's boat, and he woke up. It looked like he drained around 5 pounds because he was sweating so much down deep in the hull of his boat with no ventilation whatsoever. And Chuck was covered in bug bite welts and the morning dew. So he was soaking wet and covered in bug bites. So that was an interesting experience. And that's where we parted ways. And I continued south by myself from New Smyrna. I bid them farewell and continued south to Palm Beach, where I pulled into the Megayacht Marina there and overnighted there. Had a really nice night, pretty low key. Hung out in the the crew quarters there. They had a pool table, leather couches, widescreen TV, a little bar, kitchenette. Made myself some dinner. It was awesome. Sat down on Not Easy, and then next morning around 7 a.m., I headed back out and got into Port Everglades Cut at 9 o'clock in the morning. And long story short, I got pulled over by Homeland Security, which was really nice, as they were interested as to why I was a solo driver with a Georgia tag coming into Fort Lauderdale. So they asked me what I was doing, and I said I was delivering the boat from Savannah. They said, "What do you mean?" I said, "Yeah, I just took it down from Savannah." They're like, "By yourself?" I'm like, "Yeah." So that was an interesting exercise. They kind of looked me over and led me on my way. I was soaking wet. I was totally dehydrated. It was so rough on that leg, that both those legs, that I couldn't really eat or drink. I had some beef jerky and a bottle of water in the glove compartment here, but I was constantly oversteering to zigzag through the waves to try to smooth it out a little bit, and it just wasn't working. So, anyway, of course, I got to be behind the diesel delivery boat that's spewing exhaust. I can't get around it. Anyway, so, pulled it up to my house and went to put it on the bunks on the lift that came with the house when I bought it. Of course, that guy totally jacked me. That lift was completely inoperable. The tieback rods were completely snapped. I had never really used a lift before, so I didn't know. I had my buddy James McKenzie take a look at it, and he was like, "John, if you put the boat on this lift, it'll rip the whole dock into the water," which was nice. Thanks, previous owner of house. He also jacked me on the crack in the pool, so that was a nice one. And called up the guy. Yeah, I asked James who were the best guys in the business. He told me Neptune. And those guys, and Dave McGowan and Dave Humphreys, were kind enough to really help me out with a lift that they had on site. Somebody, balked on them and was able to get that installed in a couple of days before the boat even started getting some growth, which was amazing. And it's been on that lift ever since. And it's a sad day. It's been a great boat. It's been over to Bimini a few times. It's been down to Almirada, to Key Largo a number of times. Really, it's just been an amazing boat. I've overnighted on it. I've fished on it. Won, didn't win some fishing tournaments, but had some beautiful non-inclusive fish, like a sailfish, in the John Baker tournament, which was an amazing experience on a kite. And just a lot of great times with friends and family and clients. And just an unbelievable experience. I mean, it really couldn't have been a better boat ownership experience. It's a very low maintenance boat. It's easy to keep clean. It's the outboards are pretty rock solid, and I'd have my good friend Keith, the at Top Prop, do the regular maintenance. Kept it in tip top shape for me, which I always appreciate. And the last time we took it down to Key Largo, I had my in-laws, one in each corner, in captain's chairs. I had my 14-year-old in the middle in a beanbag on his phone. I had my wife bracketing our 2-year-old in between us on the helm seat here. He was falling asleep in his life jacket. And, you know, it was about an hour and 45 minute ride at 40 knots down to Key Largo, the Marriott down there, from Fort Lauderdale. And, you know, it was a calm day, but you get a little spray and the wind blow, you know, effect is not the most comfortable thing in the world, particularly for my in-laws. And so I just made the decision at that time that it was time to consider upgrading to something a little bit bigger. So we're locked in on the Pursuit 365i, which is a great boat, kind of a tweener cruiser, if you will, in the fact that it has outboards, but it looks like an inboard. It is really innovative. They have a, call it a integrated propulsion technology, which is an IPT, pretty elaborate name for a clamshell fiberglass cover that goes over the outboard motor. So it has the profile of a inboard, but it has all the benefits and maintenance and ease of use and reliability of outboards. So it's, I think it's going to be a great, you know, next step for the family. It's got a wraparound windshield. It's got full berth stateroom, midship stateroom, and a B berth. And it's going to be great for the family, and hopefully we'll be able to use the boat a lot more as a result. So I'm really looking forward to that. And then I just want to thank the people at Nautical Ventures who have kind of helped me out in the bind to allow me to do some service at their yard and the service area with my mechanic, which is kind of rare, as we all know. And given how great they've been in the customer service right out of the gate, I think I might actually assign them to broker the boat. They tell me the, you know, center console market's really hot right now, so hopefully somebody will, you know, be the new proud owner of an unbelievably great boat. And a great manufacturer, a great engine package, with an owner that's taken care of it its entire time, and even previously, another great owner. So this is my farewell song to Not Easy. You've been a great girl. I love you, and I'm going to miss you. All right? Take care. Well, this is it. Not going to be the last time I see you, but it's the last time you're ever going to be at Casa Calabrese. And I just spoke to Adriana at Nautical Ventures. She's going to take care of us. Keith is going to do some maintenance on you, and he's going to be off to a new home. You've been a great boat over the years, and we've been through a lot together. A lot of ups and downs. And I love you, Not Easy. I wish you safe seas and light winds and good times.